Hello YouTubes and welcome to yet another Fireworks Mania devlog. As you might know, I'm building a game called Fireworks Mania in my spare time while having a wife, two kids, a full-time day job and a dog. In this video I will go over three of the major things I've been working on since the last video. A new empty option in the tool menu, a destructible treehouse and an exploding gas station. So let's get into game dev mode by having a cup of coffee and some sweet lo-fi music. The suggestion for a new option in the tools menu for an empty option actually came from one of the community members in the Discord called
Le Valfeur.
And it's actually a really good idea that
Le Valfeur
had here, because it also annoyed me that I couldn't do a video or screenshots without having the tool in the way. So thank you to
Le Valfeur
for suggesting that. It's now implemented and will be a part of the full game coming out in December. And speaking about the initial release of Fireworks Mania in December, you can follow the link in the description to the Steam store page and hit that little wishlist button to get notified once the game is released. The game has just passed 2,500 wishlist, but there's room for many more. Enough about that, let's move on with the agenda. As I've shown in some of the previous devlogs, I'm starting to make some of the objects and things in game destructible, so that if a rocket or some explosive get too close to it and have enough power, it will actually blow into pieces. And this time around I looked at the treehouse. I know many of you have had an urge to blow it up, so I was thinking, well, it might be a good candidate to make destructible. I also made some other stuff destructible, but I won't share that. You will have to find them yourself in the full game in December at some point. But let's start with the treehouse. And this is part where it might get a little nerdy, but I guess as you are watching this video, you might be a little interested in how things actually work in a game like this. Making things destructible in a game can be done in many ways. I've picked a way where I have a solid model, for instance for the treehouse, in the game at runtime when you run around, and then when enough force is applied to it, it switches out that model with another model that is actually cut into pieces. So that means that to start on this, I need to cut up the treehouse in all the planks, or at least all the pieces I wanted to. So I could cut it in half, or I could cut it in whatever, each plank or whatever. So let's get into Blender and start by doing that, so I have another model of it that is actually in different parts. With the model chopped up in different pieces, I can export it and take it into Unity and assign some colliders to each of the parts so they can interact with the physics in game once this model is spawned. It's not always things turn out the way you want the first try, so here you can see me trying to blow it up where it doesn't work because it has too much health or doing too little damage, and then once it actually explodes, you'll see that the pieces interact with the world in a total realistic way. Bouncing around like that. But with a little magic I managed to fix that, so it now looks more correct, so we can move on to explode more stuff like the gas station. Based on the videos I've seen on YouTube and the streams on Twitch, it seems like a lot of players want to blow up the gas station, so of course I had to implement that. First up, I added a little destructive magic to the gas pumps so they can blow up like this if enough force is applied. And then later on I chopped up the gas station or the cover above the gas pumps, similar to what I just did with the treehouse, so it can also blow up in different pieces with a beautiful big explosion. A little disclaimer here is that this is something I'm building for the full game, so it will not be in the demo, and also I am actually currently working on this, so it might look and feel a little different in the full game that comes out in December, where you can try it out for yourself. If you like this video, remember to leave a like, and if you want to see more stuff like that and won't miss it, hit the subscribe button and the little bell notification to get notified once I put up a new video. If you like the game and think it looks interesting, you will find a link in the description as previously mentioned in the video, where you can go to Steam and add the game to your wishlist. While waiting for the next video, you can watch some of the videos showing up on screen right now and see more of the game Fireworks Mania, which I share the progress of here on this channel. See you in the next video!